When we hear the term adult movies, we might immediately think of a carnival of debauchery. Fortunately, movies for adults can be quite mainstream. Crude language and risque innuendos aside, the R rating has been of great help for filmmakers who wanted to add a little spice to their films. However, some of these R-rated movies were initially rated NC-17 by the MPAA, making the line between dirty and decent somewhat blurred. In today's list, we'll be looking at the top 10 adult movies that were rated R. Number 10, Damage. Having an affair is sordid enough for most of us, but having said affair with your son's fiancé is borderline unthinkable. That's the dilemma of Damage, a 1992 drama starring Jeremy Irons and Juliette Binoche. Irons plays Dr. Stephen Fleming, a physician who entered politics and becomes a member of parliament. He meets his son's fiance, Anna, and soon begins a passionate romance with her. Fleming seems to stop caring about the dangers that such an affair could mean, not only for his career, but also for his family.
What's all this?
We're not going to have a white wedding, as I've already moved in with Anna.
He's just laughed when I told him.
Yes, come on!
As the plot would suggest, Damage features a heavy dose of intimate scenes between Irons and Binoche as their characters get intimate in increasingly explicit scenes. This, coupled with the film's delicate subjects, created a lot of controversy for the ratings board. Part of this controversy would personally impact actress Juliette Binoche, who would famously speak ill of her co-star, Jeremy Irons. Binoche said that the English actor would act some of his intimate scenes with her a bit too realistically, being somewhat uncomfortable during the filming. That said, the actress has said in later interviews that she forgives Irons and that she had a good time working with all of the members of the cast of Damage.
You want us to start eating breakfast together?
Yes, I would like that.
Would you? Would you actually like it if we lived in the same house, read the papers together?
Number 9, The Cooler. Ever feel like nothing's going your way? That's how every day feels like for Bernie Lutz, the main character of The Cooler, a drama about the unluckiest man in Vegas and how getting a bit lucky almost costs him his life.
Bullshit, shut him down right now. Shut him down or I will. Not
here. Bernie Lutz is a man with a luck so bad that it is contagious. He works in the Shangri-La Hotel and Casino, where the boss uses his talent to jinx the winning gambler's luck. Things change for Bernie once he meets Natalie, a cocktail waitress, and begins a relationship with her. Now, instead of bad luck, he seems to be a lucky charm, which heavily displeases the director of the casino.
This little prick is your son?
Bob, you gotta help me out here.
Shut up!
The Cooler has some gratuitous use of off-color language, but it faced some problems due to its many suggestive scenes. In fact, two versions exist of this film, a tamer, R-rated version, and a fully uncut NC-17 one. Even more impressive is the movie's use of expletives. We're talking about a total of 101 F-bombs in a movie that's 101 minutes long.
I'm gonna pretend like you give a shit and tell you she's getting by as long as she's high.
Number 8, Basic Instinct. This sleazy 1992 noir thriller was directed by Paul Verhoeven, who's unquestionably no stranger to spicy scenes and gratuitously violent movies. Basic Instinct is a classic of the neo-noir genre, featuring what's been called the most paused moment in the history of movies. Michael Douglas plays Detective Nick Curran, a violent cop who's investigating the murder of rock star Johnny Boz.
How long were you having sex with him?
About a year and a half.
Were you with him last night?
Yes.
His investigation quickly focuses on Boz's girlfriend, a crime novelist called Catherine Trammell. The novelist makes clever use of her womanly charms to manipulate the investigation, seducing Curran in what seems like an attempt to evade the police. Catherine Trammell is played by Sharon Stone, who plays the part of the nymphomaniac novelist perfectly. One of the film's most infamous scenes features Stone uncrossing her legs in front of the camera. This single frame is what's been called the most paused moment of every movie, at least according to a poll by Love Film, a now defunct movie subscription service.
What good's a shooter without his gun?
How exactly did you find out?
I have attorneys. I have friends.
Number 7, American Pie. A true comedy classic, American Pie defined a generation of comedies with its raunchy humor and its representation of American high school life. The story follows the misadventures of four friends who make a solemn pact. They promise they'll lose their virginity before their prom night.
Yeah, we were up all night together. We had one of those amazingly deep conversations where you feel like you really get to know someone.
The movie's infamous for its bawdy humor, especially considering that some of its characters are supposed to be underaged. It reportedly took the film 4 tries before it received an R rating, being given the harsher NC-17 rating on multiple occasions. American Pie has become a staple of adult comedy since its release. That said, not every country has the same standards in their ratings boards. In Denmark, the movie was rated A, which means that it can be seen by everybody, regardless of their age.
I highly recommend you join the club. We are doing the wild thing all night. I'm exhausted.
Number 6, Team America, World Police. Created by the same guys responsible for South Park, Team America is an irreverent comedy that pokes fun at American foreign politics and action movies in general. A true product of its time, this puppet film ridicules the concept of America being the de facto world police after the events of 9/11.
Hey guys, I think we should pull over.
Pull over? Yes, of course! Pull over, let them pass us, and when they turn around, we charge them!
Most of the characters in the film are voiced by their creators, Trey Parker and Matt Stone. The plot follows Gary Johnston, a popular Broadway actor who's recruited into Team America, an elite counter-terrorist organization thanks to his acting skills. Just like South Park, Team America looks deceptively cartoonish as its crude jokes and explicit scenes betray its R rating. Just like with American Pie, Team America was rated differently in America and Europe. The film almost received an NC-17 rating in America, but in several European countries, the movie was considered to be for kids and family. Seems like America and Europe have different standards when it comes to potty mouth puppets.
Susan Sarandon!
Oh, thank God! We have to stop the ceremony! Kim Jong-il is mad! Here, let me loose. I'll show you where the theater is.
Number 5, Blue Valentine. This experimental film centers on the relationship of Dean and Cindy in a non-linear way. Jumping between time periods, the movie presents many key moments of their relationship, with the audience being the ones that have to piece the memories together to understand their relationship. Blue Valentine offers a somewhat nihilistic analysis of how modern relationships begin and end.
I can't do this anymore. I don't want her to grow up in a home where her parents treat each other like this.
The movie also features a healthy dose of profanity and explicit scenes between its protagonists, and that's exactly the reason why it was given an R rating. Ryan Gosling and Michelle Williams play the Dean and Cindy, the lead characters of the story. To better understand the relationship of their characters, the actors lived together for a month, learning how to pick fights with each other.
Not going outside with you. I've had it.
Come and talk to me.
I am up to here. I'm done, okay? I'm done.
Number 4, Boys Don't Cry. Based on the real-life tragedy of Brandon Tina, Boys Don't Cry is a harrowing movie about the stigma of the early days of transgenderism in rural America. Starring Hilary Swank as Brandon Tina, a young woman who adopts a male identity and begins a romantic relationship with Lana Tisdale, a single mom.
Graceland is in Memphis, and Memphis is in Tennessee.
I know.
Released in 1999, the subject matter of the film was considered a bit too controversial at the time. The depictions of the brutal abuse that Brandon suffered towards the end of his life are also painfully disturbing, earning this movie its well-deserved R rating. To prepare for her role, Hilary Swank spent a month living as a man. This included asking girls out, an experience that the director, Kimberly Pierce, insisted that she had to go through to fully understand her character.
Why didn't you leave? We can still do it.
Number 3, American Psycho. A surrealist and violent look into the mindset of a New York City investment banker, American Psycho has become one of the most popular cult films of the early 2000s. The movie stars a very young Christian Bale as Patrick Bateman, the film's titular psycho.
Listen, I cannot understand you! This is crazy! You're a fool! I can't cope with this stupid bitchy! Understand?
Bateman is a man with an obsession with perfection, but also crippled by hedonistic fantasies and episodes of violence. As the film progresses, we begin questioning what is real and what has been created by Bateman's disturbed psyche. Christian Bale did a wonderful job playing the terrific Patrick Bateman, but the role almost went to Leonardo DiCaprio, who chose to leave the project in favor of the film The Beach.
I just had to kill a lot of people! And,
Number 2, South Park. Bigger, longer, and uncut. The cartoon that changed the face of satirical comedy in the 90s had its big screen debut in 1999. South Park, bigger, longer, and uncut, is a hysterical musical that throws logic out the window to poke fun at everything and everyone.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy. They may be right. They may be right.
Featuring a singing Saddam Hussein, the plot of the South Park film follows a conflict between the US and Canada, after the Canadians are blamed for corrupting young people's minds with their crude humor. This irreverent comedy also has some musical elements thrown in it, and was even nominated for an Oscar for its song, Blame Canada, one of the only songs in the soundtrack that didn't contain any swear words. Well, at least, it's the one with the least amount of swears. Our number one pick is Clerks. A true cult classic, Clerks offers a cheeky look at the life of two convenience store clerks who just try their best to make it through their daily grinds.
I'm gonna break your fucking head, you fucking jerk!
I'm sorry, he meant to hit me! Yeah.
The film chronicles a day in the life of Dante Hicks, a clerk who relies on his friend Randall to keep him entertained while he covers for another employee on his day off. Originally rated NC-17 just because of its graphic dialogue, a Harvard law professor actually convinced the MPAA to give it an R rating instead. Clerks was filmed on a minuscule budget and on a tight filming schedule. The convenience store featured in the movie is the same one where Kevin Smith was working at the time. Smith had to work there during the day and film during the night, which meant that he rarely slept during the 21 days of filming.
I understood that you were three different guys and that's all you said!
Please calm down.
How many?
Dante.
How many have you...
Do you agree with our list? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and be the first to receive new top 10 videos from Stream TV.